warmest greetings to all the participants of the ABLF Talks Live. Thank you for creating this platform to discuss how we can emerge stronger from the challenges brought by the pandemic. By now, I am sure we all have become starkly aware of the impact of COVID-19 on businesses and economies. In 2020, developing Asia suffered its first regional recession in 6 decades, with most major economies posting negative growth. Globally, we have seen how even the most established businesses are struggling to stay afloat, while smaller shops have been forced to close their doors. Earlier reports have shown that 94% of Fortune 1000 companies are seeing supply chain disruptions because of the pandemic, while 75% of companies have already been feeling the blunt force of this pandemic as early as March last year. The choice for many has been to either let go of employees or to fold up, resulting in one of the highest unemployment rates on record. This, of course, has caused tremendous anxiety and uncertainty. The virus will be with us for a while, and it can be difficult for us to imagine what the future holds, much less plan our actions moving forward. So we ask ourselves, how do we remain resilient during this time of great unrest? What does business look like in a post-COVID-19 world? How do we build back better and reimagine a future where no one is left behind? There is no single sure answer to these questions. But though contexts may differ, it has become abundantly clear. If we want to emerge stronger from this crisis, innovation and collaboration in the service of the most affected presents the best way forward. There are several ways of fostering the spirit of collaboration. One is by engaging with different groups from both public and private sectors to create meaningful change across the board. Look for ways to link up, find commonalities, and work on advocacies and projects together. Expand your networks and deepen your connections so that we can fill more gaps and be bridges where we can. For us at the Office of the Vice President, this meant collaborating with many groups, including those in the private sector, to help push our initiatives forward. Working with subject matter experts and talents from the creative industry, consulting with public health experts and economists, and even engaging with youth groups to come up with the best and most effective solutions that we need right now. Second, and this is one of our personal learnings during the pandemic, is to leverage technology, to use it not just as an afterthought, but as a foundational tool in operations. Harness it to speed up and scale up. Invest in apps and other digital platforms that could make our systems flow smoothly, where the dynamics between health and efficiency can be addressed. This has been the philosophy behind some of our COVID-19 response efforts. We launched an online community mart which lets customers shop for their market needs with the help of an app. Through this, market vendors had an online platform to sell their goods, and tricycle drivers who did not have any source of income during the lockdown were able to ply their routes. We also launched an online jobs matching platform called Seekup.ph, which aims to provide employment to blue-collar workers affected by the pandemic. Another initiative called Iskaparate.com helps home-based entrepreneurs and small business owners develop an online presence. The same impetus of working together and harnessing technology to find new solutions becomes even more necessary with the current crisis as our background. This is, after all, what being resilient means. Resilience means being creative in front of limitations, being agile despite roadblocks, being focused despite distractions. Resilience is not a static quality, but one characterized by forward movement, crafting the most efficient pathway towards a solution, making things better for everyone else. Being resilient is not just about overcoming adversity. It means evolving, taking in every lesson from these adversities, and using it to ensure that we will have a better, more strategic response to similar crises in the future. As the pandemic has shown us, turning things around entails going beyond old ways of thinking, hoping to weather storms on our own, operating within our own bubbles of self-preservation. Turning things around entails beginning to understand that ultimately, for the economic ecosystem to truly flourish, the most vulnerable among us must be empowered. They are, after all, the same people who man our workstations and the same people who stand to be end consumers as we travel further down the process chain of our products and services. And so, as you work to regain your momentum, let us also ensure that we minimize the health risk for our workers. Physical distancing and minimum safety practices must become entrenched in the culture of our workspaces. Some of you may already be implementing work-from-home arrangements in your companies, but it might be more strategic and even more beneficial if we look at the long term already, reorienting all our systems and technologies to conform with the demands of today, bearing in mind that we might never go back to exactly where we used to be. Our work is far from over. Today, we are all called to intensify our efforts. More of us need to do the work so that we can find even more ways to move towards a better normal. This is the best place to start. The best business minds in the region are already here with us today. As you discuss each other's views on how businesses can adapt to the challenges of this pandemic, I have no doubt that you will find more opportunities to collaborate and innovate. In doing so, it is my hope that you will be fueled by the same grit and determination that has strengthened you and your businesses after all these years. Use this to reimagine a future that works for all, to empower the communities where you belong, to support other sectors in your midst, to do good and honest business, and ultimately to contribute to the bigger project of building a better, fairer, more resilient, and more equitable world. Thank you very much, and may you have a productive forum.